できない子だったんで、なんかこうでもずっと続けてればどんどん強くなれるし結果も出るんだっていうのを自分が優勝して何ですか見せれたりとか。
昨年女子高生ファイターとしてライジンデビュー、ハッピーエンドを目指した彼女の格闘ストーリー、そこには家族の愛が欠かせません。
純情可憐タックル女子朝倉環奈、格闘技好きの父に強引に導かれた少女のレスリング人生。
6時に起こしてもう毎日走ってましたね。もう家の周りで有名です。
格闘技も父親も嫌いだった。
宿題やるなら懸垂やるとか、遊び行くなら懸垂やるとか。
でもやり続けたら周りに笑顔があふれたから。
自分は本当にできない子だったんで、本当全然格闘技のセンスもなくて、そこを頑張りに変えて、
みんなカンナに元気をください。
器用な戦いだけど、私はこれに決めたから。
決勝で日本人対決がしたいです。
絶対勝つ。
でもリーナさんめっちゃ強かったから。
うわまた出たこいつ。
Até porque eu vou fazer duas lutas, né? Então, quanto mais rápido eu acabar, melhor.
ブラジリアンスパイダーガール、マリア・オリベイラ。トーナメント1回戦、長すぎる手足を駆使した打撃で相手を圧倒。ノリに乗るスパイダーガール、驚異の KO 率を誇る、戦うために生まれた超人ガール。私の試合は私だけのものじゃない。
石岡選手の分までトーナメント勝ち上がっていきたいなと。
できない子かもしれないけど、
また練習しよう。
女子スーパーアトム級トーナメント準決勝、マリア・オリベイラ VS 朝倉環奈。
Here from Japan, Kana Asakura, 9-2 in mixed martial arts, standing 5'2", weighing 107 pounds. We asked her so many times about the tournament and what's your thoughts about competing in the tournament. She says, look, I'm looking for a perfect fight here. I do not want this to go to the decision. I want a first round knockout so I can get some rest. And again, knowing full well that the bullseye is on Reyna.
You know, we're going to start talking about the guys in the bantamweight tournament. They're the final fight of the night. They fought the first two fights of the night. They'll fight the last fight of the night. They've had the most amount of rest. The kickboxing fighters, and then the women are fighting co-main event, and then the swing bout. They're fighting. They're having a lot less rest after they win these fights. So for them, really getting out of here without any damage is a big deal, because you have. And it sounds silly. 20-minute rest versus a 40-minute rest, but at the end of the night, that's a big difference between somebody being able to be completely recovered, the swelling out of my legs, the swelling out of my eyes, versus someone's like, I'm still a little sore, I'm still a little beat up, and you go in there and get more beat up and more sore. And she's right. She is very smart. Well, she wants to get out of this fight as quickly as possible, make this a very balanced fight very, very early, and get home.
Absolutely. She's a very, very peaceful individual. speaking with her, just you could tell how calm she is. And you and I were like, do you believe she's a fighter? Do you believe she's just a mixed martial artist that goes out there and punches people? She's just such a nice human being.
All smiles, all respect the entire time. She is really what's happening at her age. She is what is becoming of mixed martial arts worldwide, where it's much more respectful at the younger age, not so much more into talking trash and picking on your opponents. They're trying to make it work. Where a lot more respect is coming forward.
Representing Brazil, Maria Oliveira, 10-2 in mixed martial arts. She stands 5'6", weighed in at 107 pounds. In our conversation with her pre-fight wise, we just asked, you know, what's life like for you nowadays and what makes you tick? And she just basically said, I'm a girly girl. I like my movies. I like going out shopping. Love testing out new types of makeup. Which is sad that she wasn't able to fight with her brand new nails.
Yeah, she had a great nail job done before she came in. In a pre-fight interview, she was very proud of her nails. She said she's a girly girl. She really went out, went all in, pedicure, manicure, and then was informed, hey, the nails got to go.
7 of her 10 wins have come by stoppage, 6 of them knockouts. She's currently a 9-fight win streak. She brings it. She's got exceptional skills. But she also said in this fight here, because we asked her, you know, this is a tournament. You know, what's the goal here? She said, you know what, I want to get a feel for, you know, competing this evening, maybe play around a little bit. But the bottom line is, I'm going for that knockout. And I want that knockout after a few minutes.
Well, let's look at her record here. First fight out ever in mixed martial arts, loses by armbar. Gets a win, TKO punches her second fight, loses a majority decision after 3 rounds in her third fight, and then has won the next 9 in a row. Talking about somebody that had to hit a lot of adversity in the very beginning, had to learn how to come through it, just was not honed down as a full mixed martial arts fighter. Basically just thought to be more of a street fighter and thought that would work for her. It didn't at all. She readjusted, got her stuff together, started listening to the experts within her gym, started listening to veterans, and now she's doing my fight history.
Here's how the two ladies stack up against one another. Age, fairly similar. 4-inch height advantage for Oliveira. Records are similarly close, with Maria having one more victory on her resume. Second round of the tournament. Here we go.
Tadaima yori, Joshi Super Atom Kyu Tournament, Junkesshou, Daini Shiai wo okonaimasu. Ao Kono, 158cm. 48.75kg. Asakura Kanda! Aka corner, 167.5cm. 48.7kg. Maria Oliveira! Referee, Jason Hartog.
Now, this match is ライジン 女子 MMA トーナメントルールで行われます。
Both ladies very respectful here, Frank. Ready to rock. One of these two will take on Reyna in our co-main event this evening to crown the Women's Super Atomweight Tournament Final Champion. Sakura on the outside. Oliveira, center of the ring, stalking away. Right hand landed by Oliveira.
Obviously, Oliveira, the much taller fighter. He's used that length. Sakura actually fights long for her size, but will obviously have to step aside due to the length disadvantage.
Sakura trying to use her wrestling, trying to get Oliveira down to the ground. Southpaw, he's an orthodox fighter. Inside kick by Oliveira, trying to put her in the corner. Which usually means Sakura would like to dip. Happens again, trying to dip the blow for that takedown, or smart move. She doesn't want to go down just yet. Get out of dodge.
Look at Oliveira's style.
Nice jab there by Oliveira.
If you feel like you've seen it before, very picturesque Anderson Silva. That's her basic style when she tries to fight on top of him. She mimics Anderson Silva and has her whole career. And as a result, she has been, a lot of people are starting to say she looks like a lot like Anderson with a knockout power.
Well, she mentioned that she absolutely loves Anderson Silva. Just looks at him like the god. Just loves his style. Tries to mimic it. Not a bad idol to have in mixed martial arts when it comes to style. Sure. Back in the day, this fighter was just human matrix.
Shoot, even now, he didn't get older. He'd still be one of the fiercest
entry there.
Whoa, big strength, nice running double. Whoa, good pickup, good position change. Nice job swinging her legs out. Unfortunately, somehow she ended up in half. She ended up all the way to the side. This way, she swung her legs out. She had to give credit to Oliveira for getting her leg back inside. But now she's caught, and this is where she does not want to be, underneath, against the ropes, with Asakura on top of her.
Asakura did have her head underneath the right arm. She's doing it again. Obviously trying to set up the head and arm choke once again. Squeezing away. Putting all the pressure. Driving down, driving her opponent into the mat. Trying to get her left leg free. Now using punches. Oh,
nice
just
position.
Pounding away here. Just pounding away. Oh. Oliveira able to get her hand free. But now, once again, as you can see here, Asakura. Jason Hirong is now asking the ladies, trying to bring the ladies away from the ropes. Fighting once again. Asakura and Mount.
Nice and tight, hips down, legs turned up, using her hamstrings to hold it in there. Now, what is Oliveira going to do down here? Like, how is she going to get out of this position? Start stepping one of her legs out, one of her legs free. Once that leg is free, turn that hip down and start shrimping yourself out of there. You can't do that, though, with that overhook. On her right side, she has an overhook. She's trying not to get hit. You're not going to be able to get out, though. What she's making the biggest mistake is a person on the bottom needs space to be able to move. The person on top wants no space, so they can't move, and she's holding her in.
And Sakura easily able to get those hands trapped and pounding away. Now you see Oliveira trying to buck, trying to get some sort of space there.
Right back in there again, keeps getting caught. She's holding herself in this position with that overhook. She's trying to buck up, but she can't get anywhere. Unfortunately, this is one of those positions, Joe, where it's going to suck. You want to get out? You're going to have to take a couple punches. So you take a couple punches to get out, and you sit down there and take a dozen punches. Now there's a hand cop. Going to force up the up. Yep, walk your hand across. Going to force that elbow up. Looking for that. There it is.
There's a right knee up from before. Looking for the head and arm choke. Side choke for some of you folks out there.
Get it locked up and step all the way over.
She's got just under a minute to make it work. While Oliveira has to figure out a way to defend and get out of this position, she's using, or was using, the phone booth technique, or hand to the phone to the ear technique.
Okay, that's a mistake on Asakura. She had it locked up, but she didn't try to get to the side. She stayed in full mount. As a result, it gave the ability for Maria to move her head to the side. Like you said, use the telephone technique, and was able to move her hand out and get out of that choke. She was completely caught, but because Asakura made a mistake and not stepping over, she's out of it.
Oh, look for the armbar attempt here. Here comes the armbar setup. She's got 23 seconds to do it.
She'll go Kimura. She'll go topside Kimura. She'll turn her head. Well, if she can suck her head in, cast that head up, she'll be able to turn it in. Maria did a good job of getting her head out. So as a result, she's never able to get that Kimura locked in.
Oliveira able to survive. 10 seconds left in the round. Trying to throw the combination there. Trying to land some punches there. But as it stands right now, Asakura wins this first round. You don't judge by a round here in Japan. But thus far, the fight is being won by Asakura. If you're in Oliveira's corner, what kind of advice are you giving her?
Use your length, use your distance. You have to throw more. Know she's going to shoot on you, so you can't keep your hands that high. See how high her elbow was? And when she got picked up, she really didn't try to sprawl. She got sucked in right away and got dumped to the side. Did a good job of putting her in the half guard before she getting caught here. But here, she's just getting pounded before she finally gets her hand out of the way. Maria's got some really good position change. She understands how to get in and out of spots very, very well. But unfortunately, she's got to use her length more. She's got to keep her hands just a little bit lower, because Asakura is 100% going to shoot on her again because of the length differential. If I'm Asakura, I'm going to try to keep doing the same thing that I'm doing. I'm just going to keep shooting on her and try to get her to the ground as much as possible. But this time, when I get her down to the ground, I'm going to have to make sure but I step to the side and get a submission, lock it up, and make sure that if I get the head and arm, get out of the mount and try to finish it. If I got the Kimura, make sure I catch her head and finish on the top side.
Seems like she's physically much stronger.
Yes,
than Marie. She's able to just move her arms and just get things out of the way much easier. So it's a matter of just closing that distance, getting back to where this fight needs to be for her. Well, Oliveira, like you said, found a way.
He needs to try to cut off the ring. She's just following her right now. She's not cutting her off.
Oh, nice shot landed there by Rivera. Or excuse me, Oliveira.
Oh, much better job of defending takedown.
Great job. Still got that. We're able to get it back down the ground. Now she's got over 4 minutes to work here, trying to get a submission right back to the head and arm choke, basically what she's trying to set up here. But the way she competes on the ground, the way she likes to mix things up, could be anything.
Yeah, she's a wide array of topside submissions that she likes to go to. And as you can tell earlier, she could have went armbar, but she went Kimura instead and lost it in the first round because she likes to stay on top. She won't give up top position. She prefers to stay there, and which makes a lot of sense. Why work your butt off to get the top position, then give it up by working for an armbar? That may or may not work.
She's trying, and you can see Oliveira just dragging her elbow down, trying not to let it happen, but slowly but surely, she's trying to trap the legs. Sakura keeping the grip up top.
Put him out, readjust that head and arm choke, and then step to the side. She's going to sit up mount, or she can sit up right here. She has her locked in nice and tight. She could throw a couple punches from here. It'll be okay.
Frying pan into the fire, Frank Trigg.
Yeah, and let's be honest, Maria Oliveira is holding herself in this position. She's not giving her the ability, giving herself space to get out, and she's helping Sakura hold her in this spot because she keeps bringing her down.
Back in the mount, stabilizing position. Like I said before, she's got this power just easily overpowering Oliveira anytime there's technique there. Driving now, once again, this is going to be punches. You're going to start flying again.
She'll go triangle. She'll go topside triangle. She let it go. She had a triangle position. She wanted it.
She readjusted the position, dropping her knees back down. Now she's going ground and pound for mount. One thing Oliveira can do here is either hold her here or some way, somehow, you got to get out of the mount position here.
She's a great job.
No matter what she's doing, jumping out of the frying pan into the fire, you do this, you get caught here.
Sakura does a great job of lifting her knees up, bringing her knees up and down, up against the bicep. Now she's moving her left knee up underneath the shoulder. She's always sneaking in. She's looking for submissions on the top, but then also slides back immediately if she starts getting dumped off, so you keep the hips controlled. Excellent work here. I mean, Maria, at this point, you just let go and buck her hips, would have threw her off, but she's holding herself in there. Now she's sitting there taking more damage.
Oh, the armbar technique, Frank.
Oh, she gave up position. Nice job crossing her feet. She keep her there.
Taking her time, turning it over, pulling on the outside. Thumb up in the air. There's the tap. Sakura guarantees an all-Japanese final in tonight's Women's Super Atomweight Tournament. She'll be taking on Reina in the finals in our co-main event this evening. Fantastic job. She dominated Maria Oliveira. Fantastic work with her takedowns, her grappling, setting up the position. Obviously, Oliveira dejected, not expecting this. Come into a fight you expect to win. She's been very respectful. It's all done.
I think part of it too is that Maria Oliveira didn't think she was going to get. She's accepting the fact that she's going to lose at some point. That's how it goes. But she got dominated pretty much from top to bottom, and that's difficult to deal with when you're doing so well. You're on a 9-fight win streak. Like you're like, this is, things are going well for me. So all of a sudden, run into somebody that completely dominates you. It's a little bit of a humbling experience. And I think that's what happened to her. She just caught nothing she could do.
Wow, that was a fantastic armbar. You saw the elbow caps going up in the air past the 180 degrees that our human bodies, or our human arms should go. Let's hear now from our winner. Thanking everybody.
Rising, 出場して初めて一本で勝つことができました。この調子で決勝戦まで。
She says I was able to finish the fight for the first time ever since I made my debut.
決勝戦楽しみにしていてください。ありがとうございます。
朝倉環奈選手の女子トーナメント決勝戦、ぜひご期待ください。
I will fight like this to win this tournament. In essence, replicating this exceptional performance, you would think that she's going to try and get Reyna down to the mat and make her pay something, you know, Irene Rivera tried to do, wanted to do, but Reyna's punching is absolutely fantastic. Here we look at again, once again, the finish, the armbar. Once she swung her legs over, all the pressure was on just to break the wrist, break the grip, bring it off to the side, extend the arms, lift your hips up, bring the elbow past its point of flexion, and you're good to go.
And that's not her normal armbar. She usually does a topside armbar where she's belly down, and she won't give up the top position, like I said earlier. And that one, she just knew that she had her locked up so much, once she crossed her ankles, she wasn't going to be able to turn into her, and she was able to finish the armbar off. She ripped through that grip. She didn't use any grip-breaking techniques at all. She just ripped.